Suffering diaries comes from the state of Karnataka. We all know someone who's had tragedy knock on their door where COVID-19 is concerned. Most of us are those people. We all know families that have completely been wrecked by the virus. And there are some stories which leave you completely numb. This story of a 10-day-old infant coming in from Karnataka, filed by my colleague Nabila.
Five days after this baby was born, COVID-19 made her an orphan. This heart-wrenching story is from Mandya in Karnataka of a child who was yet to be named by her parents. For 9 years, Mamta and Nanjunde Gowda anxiously waited for a child. Finally, their prayers were answered and they were blessed with a cherubic child. But fate had something else in store. 5 days before she was born, her father, Nanjunde Gowda, died of COVID. Then the virus killed her mother. The infant too caught COVID but quickly coped with treatment and is now stable at the Mandya District Hospital.
Clinically stable. It's not on any medications as such. It's a good weight baby weighing almost 3.3 kgs. Doesn't have any complications. We have tested on day 1 and as well as day 5 of life for COVID, and both the test samples have come negative.
I just got a glimpse of the little child. She's doing fine, she's stable and absolutely beautiful, I should say that. It's so devastating to know that the child is left alone. Both the parents have succumbed. The parents' family members say that they will come claim the child once they get all their RT-PCR test reports and they're negative. Then they will come and take the child home. But as of now, the child is left alone at the hospital. She's not been named. It's unfortunate. 9 years of wait, the family, in fact, the mother and father, Mamta and Nanjan Gowda, they waited for 9 years, prayed for a child to happen. Finally, the child was born. 5 days before she was born, the father passed away. 5 days after, the mother passed away. With both parents dead, the child will be handed to the State Child Welfare Committee after she is fit to leave the hospital.
The child is doing fine. She is at the district hospital. The first preference is given to the child's family, that means blood relatives. If they don't want to take the child, then the CWC will take decision for legal adoption. We follow strict adoption procedures.
The CWC, doing due diligence, first approached the child's father's family. Thankfully for this child, her mother's brother and his wife have come forward to adopt her, but will have to go through all legal procedures. They already have two children, these two lovely kids, and they're really excited to have the baby home. What have you named the baby? Have you named her?
Lavanya.
Lavanya? Are you happy?
Yes.
Yes? Which class are you in?
Fifth
standard. Ah, you're very excited. You? Khushi aagta idya?
Adre avu barlilla annadonde becha. Avula bandidre chenagittittu.
Yaar bandilla?
Nanu. Avulu jothele barbekittu. Pappu jothe.
Mamta avaru. Neevu close aagiddra avar jothe? Destiny has been cruel to Lavanya. The baby's potential parents are calling her. The infant is fortunate that a loving home awaits her. Nabila Jamal, Bureau Report, India Today.
Viewers, while the first wave of coronavirus was kinder to our hinterland, the rural belt, the second wave has completely devastated it. And for most of us, we do know. Village folk are simple. When my colleague went across the Jhunjhunu district, which seen the maximum deaths where Rajasthan is concerned, what she heard was a mystery illness overtaking people. Most people said it wasn't corona, even though the symptoms completely corresponded with coronavirus. This report by my colleague Moshmi.
As Rajasthan continues to be under a lockdown and situation worsens in villages, in Jhunjhunu district's Chapoli village, there has been a spurt of sudden deaths. With many active cases and COVID having already claimed 25 lives, the village has been declared a containment zone since the 1st of May.
This beautiful mountainous region has Kadam Kund, where lots of tourists throng this place from the district. But of course, there's a lockdown and this place is deserted except a few villagers who come to take a breather here. Chapoli village is the village that has reported the maximum number of deaths in this entire district and has been turned into a containment zone. People here coming to de-stress, naturally for the villagers, first time in their lives, they've understood the boundaries of their home are actually restricted to the doorstep and do not include their fields.
Shrugging off the fact that their village has been declared a containment zone and possibly worried about being stigmatized, the villagers refuse to accept the deaths as COVID related.
गांव में इस साल तो ये 25-30 मौतें हुई, तो लोगों लगा कि भाई ये कोरोना से मौत हुई है, लेकिन ये कोरोना से मौत नहीं हुई है। 70-80 साल से ऊपर थे बुजुर्ग लोग, वो पहले से बीमार थे, कुछ मौसमी बीमारी थी, बुखार, इस तरह से उनकी मौत हुई है, लोगों को लगा कोरोना से मौत।
While the villagers of Chapoli abide by the containment rules in place, they complain that there has been no testing of late. So how can the deaths be passed off as COVID deaths?
गांव में मौतें तो काफी हुई हैं, गांव भी बहुत बड़ा है चापोली, बाकी ज्यादातर लोग काफी 80-75-90 के आसपास हुए हैं, पुरानी बीमारी से हुए हैं। ऐसा कोरोना से अभी मेरे गांव में कोई जांच तो हुई नहीं, एक दो में जरूर लक्षण थे।
In Chapoli, we met 11-year-old Pramod Nayak. With schools shut, he says he now takes the family goats to graze on the hill every day. Pramod says he is well aware of the situation in his village. Having lost family, he wants his village to take the disease seriously.
जैसे कि कोई किराने की स्टोर, मेडिकल स्टोर, इन पे जाते हैं तो दवाई लेके फिर वापस से घर पे वही सुविधा कोरोना वायरस वाली सैनिटाइजर लगाते हैं आते ही
इसे ही।
हाँ सैनिटाइजर भी है हमारे घर पे, अब टेस्टिंग से पता नहीं कि उनको डर लगता होगा कि कोरोना नहीं आ जाए।
की बात है कोई?
अब डरने की बात नहीं है, वैसे तो सही है, ये टेस्ट करा लेना चाहिए, पता तो चले कि हम पॉजिटिव है या नेगेटिव। ज्यादा तो नहीं कि 40-50 थी शादी में भी, और अब शादी माने नहीं है तो हमारे मोहल्ले में भी या गांव में कहीं नहीं हो रही शादी भी।
The villagers are in denial mode, 25 and counting, but no one wants to admit there were COVID cases. This one-year-old will never see her father again. Anil was the eldest in the family, and his family refuses to accept that the cause of his death was COVID.
मेरा भाई 25 साल का था, और उसको बीमारी भी कोई खांसी जुकाम ऐसे थी, ऑक्सीजन की कमी हो गई इसलिए हो गई, या फिर उसको हार्ट अटैक आने की भी बीमारी, तब उनकी डेथ हो गई, और कोरोना पॉजिटिव नहीं थे वो।
कोरोना रिपोर्ट करवाई थी, नेगेटिव आई उसकी, सारे परिवार वालों सबकी दिखा ली, सबकी नेगेटिव आई।
दिस फैमिली हैज लॉस्ट देयर एवरीथिंग, डेथ लीविंग बिहाइंड डिस्ट्रक्शन। Rural India is living its worst nightmare, the pandemic snatching away young lives and leaving behind a festering wound that will never be able to heal. With video journalist Satya Rothre and Naina Shikhawat, this is Mosmi Singh in Chapoli village of Jhunjhunu for India Today.
The state of Bihar has seen some heart-rending scenes coming in through the course of coronavirus. While we've seen complete the infrastructure, health infrastructure, especially in our rural belt, crumble, collapse under the massive tsunami second wave of COVID. This hospital in Purnia seems like a cow shed, where instead of doctors, cows are making the rounds of COVID wards.
Take a long, hard look at this structure. From all angles, this one visual tells you what has gone wrong in Bihar. What you're seeing on your screens is a hospital building in Purnia district. What was planned to be a modern health center now hosts cows. All around you will find fodder and cow dung.
ये है अस्पतालों की असली हकीकत बिहार में, जहां 6 साल से एक अस्पताल तकरीबन 65 लाख की लागत से बनकर तैयार है, लेकिन 6 साल से इसका उद्घाटन नहीं हुआ है, इसे खोला नहीं गया है, जिसकी वजह से जो आसपास के इलाके में रहने वाले लोग हैं उनको दर दर भटकना पड़ता है, शहर की ओर जाना पड़ता है, पूर्णिया जाना पड़ता है, मधेपुरा जाना पड़ता है इलाज कराने के लिए.
6 years ago, this building was constructed at a cost of 65 lakh rupees. But now, the Nitish Kumar government has probably forgotten this exists. This hospital does not even exist on papers.
दोष उद्घाटन में क्या है, इस अथी को ने दिया है, डॉक्टर ने आया है तो पेशेंट यहाँ से पूर्णिया कते कते जा रहा है.
बहुत ज़्यादा नुकसान हो रहा है, क्या कि ये हॉस्पिटल जो है अतिरिक्त प्राथमिक स्वास्थ्य केंद्र है, इसको जो है यहाँ पर ना ही डॉक्टर आता है, ना ही कोई जो यहाँ के प्रतिनिधि सब है, यानी कि विधायक हुए, MP हुए, किसी सब इसको इग्नोर करके चले जाते हैं, इसीलिए गांव का जो है ना सभी आदमी को काफ़ी कष्ट उठाना पड़ता है.
Villagers allege they are paying the price for their political loyalties.
यहाँ की जनता और मुखिया दोनों राजद के समर्थक हैं, यहाँ विरोधी दल के MP हैं, विरोधी दल के विधायक हैं, उच्च वर्ग से आते हैं विधायक, और क्या कहते हैं यहाँ ये पंचायत जो पूर्णतः पिछड़ी जाति के लोग यहाँ है, ये यही समावेश में आकर के इसका उद्घाटन MP कर रहे हैं, अन्य कर रहे हैं विधायक.
इफ द बिल्डिंग वॉज फिनिश्ड, इफ द गवर्नमेंट हैड हायर्ड डॉक्टर्स एंड हेल्थ केयर स्टाफ, if there were medicines and facilities, this cowshed would have been playing a major role in Purnia's war against the virus. If only. With Rohit Singh in Purnia, Bureau Report, India Today.
This story comes in from Naithala village in Bulandshahr, where 20 people have died in 22 days. You know, viewers, it's not just the administration at times to blame. Even here, our team saw many people not following COVID-appropriate behavior. No masks.
The second wave of the coronavirus has hit rural India hard. Villages untouched in the first wave have suddenly become vulnerable. Poor health facilities, absence of doctors have worsened the impact of the pandemic. Naithala in Bulandshahr in UP has lost 22 people to the virus, claim residents here.
सिम्टम्स की बात करें तो ज़्यादातर सिम्टम्स वही हैं कि किसी को ऑक्सीजन की कमी थी, बेशक उनकी एज 85 थी, लेकिन जो उनका डेथ रीज़न रहा वो ऑक्सीजन की कमी से ही रहा. हमारे यहाँ पर एक तो सबसे बड़ी कमी ये है अभी तक हमारे गांव में कि हमारे यहाँ पर कोई स्वास्थ्य अपना एक कोई अपना एक कोई चिकित्सालय नहीं है.
Villagers claim they have no option when it comes to treatment. They either treat themselves at home or turn to quacks for help. Naithala's residents claim that there is only one Ayurveda hospital and that too offers decoction only.
स्वास्थ्य सुविधा हमारे हिसाब से तो बिल्कुल गलत है, अच्छी नहीं है. बस एक आयुर्वेद चिकित्सालय है जो बेचारा काढ़े भी बांट रहा है टाइम पर, और मतलब इम्यूनिटी पावर के लिए दवाइयाँ दे रहा है. और रही बात एलोपैथिक की, तो एलोपैथिक के नाम से तो हमारे यहाँ कुछ भी नहीं है.
What makes matters worse is the lack of awareness. India Today's team met dozens of people who were not wearing masks or following distancing norms.
कोरोना बहुत ज्यादा फैला हुआ है, अभी जैसे देखते हो आज तक की टीम को वैसे ही आप मास्क लगा लेते हो.
नहीं नहीं, मैं घर से आया था, घर ही है मेरा नजदीक, तो घर में अंदर तो जरूरत नहीं है शायद मास्क की, अब अपने घेर पे जा रहा था तो लगा ली.
Even the police were found to be violating the very norms they're supposed to enforce.
पहन रखा तो नीचे आप लगाए हुए थे.
अच्छा अच्छा.
पुलिस वाले अगर जो गांव में आ रहे हैं वो लोग मास्क नहीं लगाएंगे तो संदेश गलत जाएगा ना, मास्क लगाना जरूरी.
बात तो का ही देखिए, मगर मास्क तो लगाई हुआ है, बस थोड़ा नीचे अभी तो करा है जवाई यहाँ.
Studies reveal 75% of India's health infrastructure is concentrated in urban areas, while a major part of the country's population, as you know, lives in rural India. The urban-rural divide is now playing out in a tragic way across India. With Jitendra Bahadur in Bulandshahr, Uttar Pradesh, Bureau Report, India Today.
2000. The Education Department, on the other hand, has also prepared a list and found that 73 of its staff members, including teachers, have lost their lives to corona in the past 1.5 months. If we take both these government lists to be true, over 64% of the total dead in Rajgarh district are teachers, which appears far from reality, thus giving credence to fears of government fudging official data. With Vijay Irshad Khan and Pankaj Sharma in Rajgarh, Hemendra Sharma for India Today.
With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Suffering Diaries. On the other side is To The Point. To stay tuned.